Hello, and welcome to part four of our video series on bash scripting. Today, we will be discussing bash arrays, and there are many uses. So first, we're going to show how to initialize to create a bash array, and then how to reference that bash array correctly. It's a little bit different than how the syntax for referring to a standard variable in bash. Next, we are going to show how to loop over the elements of a bash array. And then we're going to show how to leverage the array declaration when it comes to passing a variable number of arguments to a script, something we touched on in video two in this series, as well as how to read the contents of a text file into a bash array and then loop over the elements of that text file. And as always, we're going to end this video with an interactive example that I'm going to write on Quest that's going to answer a question that will touch on the topics we talk about in today's video. So bash arrays are very handy, and they just have a couple sticking points when it comes to declaring and to referencing the elements of a bash array. So to declare a bash array, all you need to do is make sure that you put a space separated list of elements inside of two parentheses. Again, as with declaring bash variables from video two, be very careful about the equal sign and make sure there's not spaces between the first parentheses and the equal sign. The trickier bit is when it comes to referring to an element of the bash array. So before, it was enough to just put a dollar sign in front of our variable declaration to extract the string, the float, the integer that we defined as that variable. With bash arrays, you need to do dollar sign and put curly brackets around it. So for instance, in Python, you might be familiar with referencing elements of a list by doing my list element zero, which you can see is the syntax that's inside of this dollar sign curly bracket. So if you think about it that way, you just have to put dollar sign curly brackets around your otherwise kind of standard looking array reference notation. Okay. To loop over each element in an array, we make use of the at symbol. So again, you can see that I have this same syntax where I have the dollar sign curly brackets. Again, dollar sign curly brackets, think array. And the at sign is, again, just like it was with declaring that there would be a variable number of input arguments to our scripts from video two. At is saying, you know, we don't know how many elements there are in this array, but loop over all of them. Okay. In addition, we can leverage this same logic when it comes to that exact thing I talked about just a second ago, which is when you want to pass a variable number of arguments at the command line to your program, you can declare a variable, in this case args, that is an array, which where each element is argument one, argument two, argument three, argument four, up through however many arguments you passed to your program. You can also get the length of the array using the syntax you can see here on the screen. And that can be useful in case, you know, you want to allow for a variable number of arguments to be passed, but you don't want someone to pass more than eight arguments. They could pass four, they could pass eight, but they can't pass more than eight. Okay. And then again, in the loop, you see we use that same syntax for looping over each element of an array from the previous slide. So you have the dollar sign curly brackets, and then the index is indexed with that at symbol as opposed to say zero or one or two or a specific number index of the array. Okay. So again, with the dollar sign at in this script, it's what we're doing is we're saying everything that's passed in the command line from the command line, which could be 8 things, 20 things, 2 things, make it an array and call that array args. Okay. Finally, and in a rather convenient bash function is this function called read, which allows you to read the contents of a text file or a comma separated CSV, you know, depending on what your data looks like, and declare a bash array to be the elements of the text file. So in this particular example, I have a text file that has elements of row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4. And what I need to do is I need to pass it a delimiter, you know, something that the internal workings of the read can use to know how it should separate each element. In my case, my delimiter is new line. So each new line of this text file should be an element of the array. And again, I use the same syntax from the previous slides to loop over and print each element of the array. So here, this would just print row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4. Okay. All right. So we're going to take these concepts and we're going to answer the following question. So today's question is, we're going to write a bash script which takes in a variable number of arguments. Specifically, these arguments are going to be a variable number of text files. And then it's going to loop over each row of those text files and print the content to the screen. Okay. So again, as always, I'll be doing this example, answering this question in one possible way here on Quest. So I have exactly 3 text files that have similar syntax, where each row is something I'd like to become an element of a bash array. And I'm going to write a program that where I can feed in these 3 text files and do the exercise. Okay. I'm going to create a bash program called myarray.sh. And the first thing I want to do is declare a variable called args, which is going to be an array whose contents are everything I pass at the command line to this script. Okay. After that, I want to loop over each element in args. Okay, so again, remember video 3 loops. I want to loop over each element in args, and then I want to read the contents of I. So I is going to be the name of a text file, and I would like to read the contents of I into another array, loop over that array, and print each line. Okay, so I'm going to say echo processing text file I. Okay, so I need to read in again with a new line separated into, we're going to call this my file array. That's going to be the name of the variable. Okay. And then I'm going to feed to it the text file. Okay. And then I need to loop over each line in the text file. So again, I have to use the same syntax, except now I'm looping over each element in my file array. I want to echo I. And then of course, as always, I gotta make sure I close up my for loops. Okay. So again, I'm going to just summarize this real quick. Everything I pass at the command line is going to be translated into an array called args. Okay. I'm going to loop over each element in the args array, which is each element is going to be the name of a different text file. I'm going to say print the line that I'm processing, you know, the first text file. And then I need to read the contents of that text file into an array. Okay. Finally, when I read the contents of the text file into an array, I need to loop over each element of that array and print it to screen. Okay. All right. So now I should be able to pass my data.txt, my data2.txt, and my data3.txt to this script. So you can see that it processed each text file and then printed the contents of those text files to the screen. Now, one really neat thing that you can do when you write a script like this is, as I said, my function takes in a variable number of arguments. And a variable number of arguments can also be a single argument with a wildcard. So in this case, instead of typing out by hand each text file's like explicit name, I can pass a single argument, wildcard.txt, and then every text file that's in this folder will actually become what is passed to this program. And you can see that the result is the same, but the order is not the same as I had passed it in manually, but the physical number of files that was processed and how they were processed is identical. All right, well, thank you so much for joining me for today's video. As always, I'm gonna leave you here with an example of a possible answer to this problem. I encourage you to try arrays out on your own, declaring them manually, declaring them based on input arguments to your function, declaring them based on the contents of a text file or data file that you have on your system. And just play around, kind of looping over each element, accessing each element. And in our final video of this series, we're going to talk about writing bash functions. So thank you so much for your time, and see you for bash functions.